Hi, good morning everyone. So today we are having a live session. So today we are going to have a live session which is going to be very unique, which I have really never done before. But today is the first time I'm going to talk with my clients who have shown a transformation. So in a way, today's session is going to be absolutely a session which is going to be an inspirational session, a motivational session for many of you. So I hope you all are safe at home. You all are taking care of. So I hope you all are safe at home. I hope you all are taking care of yourselves during the COVID-19. And as I mentioned, today's session is dedicated to my dear clients who have shown amazing transformation and have achieved their health goals in a very, very positive way. So I am going to speak with them, and I hope that will be a sense of motivation for a lot of you to achieve your health goal and move towards an effort to achieve your health goal, okay? Whatever questions you have, I will be happy to take them after I have finished talking with my clients. So keep all your questions ready. Whatever questions they are related to nutrition, related to health, I'll be happy to take them, okay? So in today's live session, I have got two special clients, and they will be sharing their amazing transformation journeys. Now, when it comes to achieving goals or, you know, achieving your staying motivated that we want to achieve a health goal, what we try to do is we try to see that, you know, we are getting motivation from some place or the other. I am sure you all will relate to this. So, you know, a situation because you're trying to achieve your health goal, probably you will have your jeans kept in your closet for n number of years, hoping that one day you will fit into those jeans. That is the kind of motivation a lot of people look up to. And this is what keeps them motivated to achieve the health goal. While some others, you know, like you might meet a friend after a few years and you might see that that friend has got lean, and then that appears as a motivation for you. You take an inspiration from that friend of yours, and then definitely, you know, you try to learn what she has done or he has done to achieve his or her health goal, and then you try to do exactly that, okay? So this is again a kind of motivation that we are looking for. So some or the other way, we try to look in for some motivation. A lot of times you might see, you know, internet is flooded with success stories, before after pictures, transformation stories, transformation journeys. And I'm sure you all might be looking at these transformation stories, taking a look at these transformation stories, because you feel that you can relate to it. You try to find an element where you can relate to the real life stories, try to translate it to your life, and you know, you try to see whether you can achieve success in that, okay? So this is again one more way of achieving motivation, and I'm sure a lot of people look forward to such kind of motivation where there are real life stories, real life examples which help you to see that the goal has been achieved, okay? So that's why today's session is dedicated to these people, two people who have shown amazing transformation, awestruck transformations, and you know, it is worth sharing their stories because I feel their stories will be an inspiration for so many of you, okay? So my first client today is Nisha. Now Nisha Mittal is an inspiration for me as well. Because agreed, you know, we act as the catalyst in helping you design a diet, achieve a health goal, motivating you wherever possible. But when I see her motivation, and it has been an amazing motivation throughout the journey of her weight loss, and she has been able to manage to lose about 45 kgs of weight, which is simply amazing, you know, a big round of applause to her. And her journey is worth sharing because, you know, when she comes and when she talks to me, she says, "Madam, mera size tha double XL, triple XL, and now I fit into clothes which are large size." This is something that is really motivating for her. Not only her, you know, people staying around her are getting equally motivated, achieving their health goals also, because they have seen that there is nothing which is impossible. So I'm inviting Nisha Mittal. And we'll be having a chat with her to understand what her journey was all about, okay? Nisha Mittal now, okay? Anita.
Hello, ma'am.
How are you?
I'm good, ma'am. How are you?
Very good. You're looking amazing as always.
Thank you, ma'am. Thanks a lot. Credit goes to all to you, ma'am. Credit really goes to you.
No, that's what I was just telling everybody. What I liked about your journey was never ever give up. You have that kind of an attitude. And that has taken you with, you know, losing about 45 kgs of weight, which is absolutely phenomenal. And I would love all the people who are listening to us right now, you know, understand what your journey is, what were your motivating things. So let's get started and just understand that. Okay. Okay. So, you know, Nisha, I'm coming to my first question for you, which is, you know, what was that one mantra that really kept you going, you know, because I understand that, you know, people do start following their weight loss journeys, but after a while, you know, it becomes very difficult to stick to that regime, to stick to the diet. Then how did you manage to, you know, keep up to your motivation? Please, everybody love to hear that.
Ma'am, first the priority for my health, when I was detected as a pre-diabetic, doctor told me, if you don't lose your weight, you're going to really have a drastic problems in your health. That made me going on. And the embarrassment for the clothes and the sizes, I used to go to the stores and I really didn't have. And I've changed from 6XL to L. I've really come down.
That is a big, big applause to you.
And I can really wear any of my outfits now because I really get them easily. And the motivation.
I have seen your amazing pictures with different kind of outfits and you look really awesome in all those outfits.
Yes, ma'am. I'm really, really happy for that. And this mantra also keeps me going on.
And you know, I think earlier your pictures were all in salwar kameez, but now I see your pictures in dresses.
Totally in outfits. Yeah, ma'am. Yes.
So your wardrobe has changed completely.
I really don't go for salwar kameezes now.
Very good. Very good.
And really, thanks to you.
I am the catalyst. You are the one, you know, who has put in all the efforts. Okay. So, Nisha, that brings me to my second question. What was the most enjoyable part of the journey? If I may ask you, you know, how many months did you take to lose these 45 kgs of weight? If everybody can just get to know that.
Yes, ma'am. Mostly 9 to 10 months.
Oh wow! And
35 kgs in 7 to 8 months. Then it was really stubborn for me to go through that. But come and visit ma'am again. But it was really, she motivated me. You can do it. You can step to the weight. And I really.
That is how it worked.
Yes.
And so what did you enjoy? Nisha, what did you enjoy? I mean, everybody feels, you know, that losing weight is very difficult.
Yes.
So what did you enjoy?
I really enjoyed my exercising to get up early morning. And really that made me active. I should go for it. Every morning, the alarm, let me sleep. No, I have to go for that. I have to do that.
Yeah.
And losing my inches every 15 days. Really
I think when you started seeing your weight loss on the scale is something that really motivated you, right?
Yes, really motivated me. And my inches, when I lose my inches and I started fitting in my old outfits, really, really I enjoyed that thing and I really still enjoy it. I still enjoy it.
Okay. The main part. Do you exercise? So Nisha, do you exercise right now in lockdown also?
Yes, ma'am. I do my walking. Early morning walking in my campus. I sit and watch for an half an hour. I really go and I do Surya Namaskars.
Oh, wow. That's lovely. So, you know, so once you make it as a lifestyle change, you know, that's what I keep on telling everybody.
I can't stay without that, ma'am.
So, you know, that is something that has transformed your life completely.
Yes,
I think that is what is very important because something that you can do every day and not just for a short period of time, right?
Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
My next question for you, Nisha, is what was the most challenging part? You know, you felt ki ye bahut mushkil hai abhi karne ke liye. Now I can't do that.
I'm getting up early in the morning and the cravings for my junk foods.
I know, Nisha, you used to eat. You used to eat a lot of hotel food.
Yes.
In and out, you used to eat. Yeah.
I still have, ma'am, but I've switched off from a regular junk foods to once in a week. Once in a week.
Yeah.
Really go for once in a week.
Yeah.
I skip one day, Sundays, for a cheat meal. But I really go for a proportion wise. Yeah. It makes me, next day I have to stand on a scale. And when I see 2 kgs, no. I'll just go from naan to a roti.
That keeps
me going on, man.
Absolutely. So, so your challenge you felt was getting up in the morning and working out. So how long did it really take for you to overcome your challenge, you know, because there is a period, you know, you need to just keep on pushing yourself. I keep on telling that to people. So what, according to you, you know, you felt ki chalo abhi na, this has become a habit. Exercise na mushkil nahi hai. Roz ke roz to
kar sakte hain. Ma'am, I can do it. So everyone can do it. I was the laziest
आपको कितना दिन लगा कि ये habit set होने के लिए आपको कितना दिन लगा मतलब?
Ma'am, actually it took me one and a half month.
That's it.
That's it, ma'am. And ki I made my mind. Nahi. When I came 15 days back to you and I saw ki I have lost 6 kgs weight. So I was really motivated. Nahi, I can do it now. And you motivate me. You can do it. You can come down to 70s also. And I've really done it now. I've done it.
So how many years were you trying to lose weight, Nisha, before coming to us?
Ma'am, mostly, mere khayal se, it was 6 to 7 years or 10 years maybe. 10 years. Okay. I really fasted for 2-3 months. I stopped. I did each and everything, but again the cravings used to come and I could have some of, and really again the weight was same. It was more than that. I used to gain more weight.
Yeah.
And that misconception. Misconception.
Yeah.
See, I'll stop.
So cravings hote the aapko? Is diet mein cravings lagte the aapko?
Yes. Thode bahut
aapko zyada cravings.
कर सकती हूँ. इट्स नॉट दैट की मैं स्टॉप कर रही हूँ. आई हैव सैंडविचेस, चीज सैंडविचेस व्हिच यू गेव मी. तो आई थॉट की हाँ, इवन दिस इज अ जंक फूड फॉर मी. आई थिंक दिस इज अ जंक फूड फॉर मी. I'll have that.
Yeah.
I had idlis in your diet and each and everything that was occupied for me, and I really filled my stomach with all that. So
okay.
I just changed the things.
Okay.
Burgers the best day. I'll go for sandwich. That is also a bread thing, a cheese thing.
Yes.
I'll go for
burgers
the best. Pizza and burgers the best. I'll go for sandwiches. I'll go for idlis.
Yes.
So ma'am.
Yes.
I made that changes.
So, Nisha, hats off to you, because I remember you used to eat a lot of Chinese food pehle, bahar ka khana. And then you
declared that only once in a week, Sundays. And I think everyone can do it. Yes, everyone can do it. Do it, ma'am.
Okay. So that brings me to the last question for you, Nisha. That is, you know, what are the changes in your food habits that you think that have made a positive change in your lifestyle?
Ma'am, very firstly, for the junk foods, the overeating, I used to really make my stomach a garbage thing. Theek hai, it's waste. Waste jaane se better hai, I'll put it in my stomach. Theek hai. But I really stopped that. And I followed your diet chart. Followed your diet chart, which was really easy for me. Which was really easy for me to follow. And you really gave me the things that I told, ki I don't want the milk thing. So you gave me the substitute for that thing. Go for almonds. I really still have almonds, which made my skin glow. And the compliments, really the compliments that I really get from my surroundings, friends, relatives. And I really enjoy my outfits. Mainly the outfits. People don't tell me, you have a 21-year-old son. That's really a compliment for me. And I really enjoy that compliment.
Lovely.
Yeah.
Acha. Nisha, all in all, if we have to conclude, I think what you started doing was a lot of mindful eating.
Yes.
And that is what kept you going. So
going on and exercising.
Yes. So, you know, regular exercising and just being mindful. It was not a restrictive diet, I remember.
You have to, ma'am, set your mind. I really see.
Yes.
And the motivation. And really the motivation.
Yes. Yes.
Really got from you and my family. Mainly my husband. Mainly my husband also. He always motivated me.
Yes,
he took
yes.
me to you whenever it's possible. Whenever you call me, he was really key. Huh? I have to go. You just get ready. I'm ready to go.
So, matlab family support bhi bahut acha tha.
Yes, ma'am. My husband, really, my husband supported me a lot. It was impossible.
Yeah, so that's it, Nisha. I'm so thankful to you. You have joined with us, shared your story
Thank
with
you.
Us. I hope it's been an inspiration for many. And please keep on going with all the good efforts that you're keeping up.
Yes, ma'am.
All
yes.
the best.
I will. Yes, thank you, ma'am. Thanks a lot for inviting
bye
me.
Bye.
Sharing my story.
My pleasure. My
okay,
pleasure.
Bye.
Bye-bye.
Bye.
Okay. So, this was Nisha with us, and she shared the journey with us of how, you know, she showed a weight loss and she was successful in a weight loss. So, Nisha, you can, you know, now exit because then
okay.
I can invite the other guests.
Okay, ma'am.
Okay. So, second client whose success story I am going to share with you is Manish Grampurohit. Now, the story about Manish is, see, he did not come with a lot of weight and it was not a major weight loss goal that he wanted to achieve. But his problem was very unique because he had rheumatoid arthritis and he was suffering from this arthritis for n number of years. So I remember, you know, I was also working with him on a project, and that is on, he's a content writer. So I was working with him on a project, and he used to, you know, a lot of times he had to cancel off one or two meetings because he was in severe pain of his rheumatoid arthritis. Then, you know, at that point in time, we realized that diet could be the only solution because he had been seeking medical advice for n number of years. And he was not getting a relief because allopathy medicines were never off. He was having the allopathy medicine every day to have his pain management. So rheumatoid arthritis is something which is an inflammation disorder, and diet has a tremendous and amazing effect on managing your rheumatoid arthritis. So this is what he did, you know, he followed my diet to the T. Hats off to him, because a few things in the diet were very restrictive, like gluten was out of the diet. Milk products were out of the diet, especially milk was out of the diet. But his efforts were amazing because he was, you know, I think his motivating factor was he wanted relief from the pain. Apart from, you know, the diet, we also have these health food products, which are millet atta and dal chila and oil, which is, you know, an anti-inflammatory oil. So he incorporated this as well into his diet, and his results were amazing. So he did not even, he just did not see a less symptoms of the rheumatoid arthritis. So his pains went down, his medications went down, and at the same time, he got a lot fitter. So he lost about 10 kgs of weight and about 5% of body fat less. So I'm inviting Manish, and I'm going to now have a chat with him to understand what his story was. Okay. Okay, we're just waiting for him to sign up with us. Hi, Manish.
Hi, how are you?
How are you?
I'm doing great.
Okay. Manish, I was just telling everybody with what the phenomenal journey that you have gone through, because you have really put in a lot of effort. And, you know, you have also followed the diet to the T, you know, because there were a lot of restrictions right. in the diet. Not very easy, you know, because the thing is, because I wanted you to get rid of these symptoms, it was very important that you get rid of the inflammatory foods in the diet. And you were phenomenal yeah. about it, you know. So would you like to just start telling about your story?
Yeah. First of all, Avanti, thank you so much for having me on this Insta Live session. I feel like a celebrity, you know, because I've been watching all these live sessions and only celebrities are being interviewed. So thanks for that.
Oh, come on.
but yeah, I mean, I was in a really bad shape, and it's not just last year or year before last. I've been having arthritis. Actually, it started with rheumatic fever, and I've been having that since 1993 when I was 17 years old. wherein you know, all my joints were actually affected, and I just could not move around. You know, because of the pain, I couldn't exercise. Obviously, you know, I was I had severe aches and pains. To top up with that, I also had severe acidity, and you know, a bloatedness I was feeling all the time. And the real hit was that last year in December, doctor, you know, they gave me a report which said that I had high cholesterol, I had diabetes, borderline diabetes, and my blood pressure was extremely high. And in my family, I have this high cholesterol, you know, there is hereditary thing.
So I
was, So I was very, very worried. And I was like, you know, I was just about to give up, that I didn't know what to do next, because, you know, it's just keeping on building up, and I didn't know what to do. So I think that's when Sunanda Verma Bhatta, she introduced me to you. And
we worked on a project also together, you remember?
Yes. Amazing. And, you know, that way I came to know a lot about diet and nutrition, how diet is not just a lingo or a word, but it's a lifestyle change, you know. So
basically, when we were working on our food products, that is where you realized, you know, like food does have a cure for rheumatic arthritis, and that is how we just started, right?
So
Manish, my first question for you, for the audience, is what is your one mantra that really kept you going?
So, like I told you, I was really frustrated with this arthritis, and you know, I had given up the fight. But then, when I met you, right, for content writing, I realized that a lot of things that you say made sense to me, and I did share with you during that meeting as well that I have arthritis. Now, I have been, you know, a very disciplined guy. I mean, let me tell you that. So, I've had so many medicines in time, you know, every time. I have exercised a lot. I have, in fact, even run marathon. I have, and for that, I followed several diets. I mean, you know, internet is flooded with all these diet plans and all these transformations. And then, you know, you just tend to follow that. And it actually made me even more miserable than I was, you know.
Yes.
So I was very confused as to, you know, why these people are finding the transformation so easy and I'm finding it so difficult. But then, you know, when I was writing about the products and all that, I realized that, you know, one product cannot work for, or one diet plan cannot work for a lot of people, you know, for everybody. So, you know, every person is unique. So, yes, when you introduced these products to me, and when you actually went through the reports, and you educated me about what to eat, what not to eat, what would heal me, what are healing foods. And mostly these were native foods, native ingredients. So I just loved that, and it had an immediate impact, you know, like within 4 weeks, all my, you know, reports were normal. So my blood pressure was normal, my cholesterol was normal, my diabetes reports were normal. And I was feeling, you know, my inflammation also came down substantially. And there is this a personal coach that I have, Gauri. And, you know, she also found the difference in my movement. So, yeah, all in all. But the mantra is,
you know, has your medicine gone down? The medicine, the dosage that you have taken?
I have not had any medicines for the past 3 months.
Okay. Manish, there's somebody who is asking a question. So let us just take that question. Okay. Discipline and sticking to, just a minute, discipline and sticking to the routine is the most difficult part for many. Could you guide a little of how you could manage that? Could you just guide a little, Manish?
Yeah. So basically, I have derived this mantra from my father. And, you know, he always used to say when I was a child that, you know, your tongue is like 10 centimeters long, but your intestine is like, you know, 7 meters, you know. And the stuff that you eat, that you taste, it remains for like a few seconds. But stuff that remains in your stomach, it lasts for hours, maybe sometimes days as well. So what would you like to keep happy? Your tongue, which is only a momentarily joy, or your gut, which is kind of, you know, long-term kind of a this thing. And it has got health benefits as well. And your products, I mean, the dal chila and the millet atta, multi-millet atta, they are healthy foods, as well as they are so very rich in nutrients, and they are so tasty.
In fact, it will be created for a particular thing in mind, like one product that Dalchila is like a high protein thing which we had created. So, you know, all those who are listening, I mean, not telling more about my products, but just because of the clients finding a need gap, these products have come up. You know, the products are born because of that reason. Okay. So, Prateek, if you ask me what the motivating factor would be for Manish, it was something to get rid of the medications that he was consuming and the helplessness that he had of the constant pain in and out, you know. So, when you're really helpless, and when you know that there is a solution available for you, let us just give it a shot. Because, you know, I have seen people with arthritis suffering from this for years and years together. So, you know, when they feel that there is a ray of hope, they'll definitely stick to it. Wouldn't you agree with that, Manish?
Yeah, absolutely. Absolutely. And, you know, it's also the another thing is that I put complete faith in you. I mean, I completely trusted you.
Thank you so much. Okay, Manish, my second question for you was, what was the most enjoyable part of the journey?
The enjoyable part was that, I mean, your plan is very, very practical. So, I did not feel caged at any point in time. It was just, you know, it's very practical with practical ingredients that you find everywhere, yeah, with your Kirana place and all that. So, the way you had planned, it was just awesome. So I did not feel hungry as well, you know, a lot of times, because I was already satiated with this plan that you had given. A couple of times I did feel a lot hungry, which is when I approached you and you tweaked the diet a little bit and, you know, adjusted it to my constitution. So
it was something because you were already eating from your normal foods is something that really was enjoyable part for you.
Yeah, absolutely. And also my stomach was light, you know, though I had a lot of energy, I felt my whatever I was eating was getting digested very, very easily. Yes. So, in fact, after eating the bhakri, I didn't feel, you know, bloated at all, or I did not, and I have not had acidity.
So basically in your case specifically, okay, I'm not really, you know, putting it like something which is a generalized thing, but if for anti-inflammatory diets, removing gluten does bring that lightness. Okay. This is for all those who are hearing. So in the anti-inflammatory, we do work on removing gluten and replacing it with options which are practical and doable in your day-to-day diet. This is very, very important. Okay. So my next question, Manish, is what was the most challenging part for you in this diet?
Obviously, I mean, the challenging part was that, you know, I love Chinese food and I love various, you know, I'm a foodie, I'm a Taurian, so I'm a foodie. I like food, pizzas and all that. So the way I, you know, every time people at my home would have that, I would want to have it a little bit of it as well. But then, you know, all I would do is I would just go walk towards the table, pick the plate up. And I would smell, you know, I mean, tongue is not just one of the senses that we have got. We've also got a smelling sense, right? So I would enjoy the, what would you say, aroma. Those, yeah, aroma of the fast food or, you know, snack items. And I would be satisfied with that.
So, you know, like when you really crave for something, then what really kept you going, Manish?
One thing was that the plan that you had given me, it was very practical. So I, you know, there was no need to go beyond that plan. I did not feel the need to go beyond that, you know. Okay. Eating anything beyond that felt like more of an atyachar, you know, for me. I mean, I think the challenging part was that convincing my family that, you know, guys, I'm full. I'm happy. If I eat more, I will be in trouble, you know. So I'm not... So it's not idealistic approach. It was practical. I mean, I could never stop myself from eating those things, which I have been able to now because I was satiated.
Okay. So Manish, my last question for you is, you know, what are the changes in your food habit that you feel are a positive change and a lifestyle change?
So like I said, that I used to have oily food and, you know, a bit of sweets, outside food a lot. Nisha, I used to also have a lot of outside food. But then, you know, I stopped all of that thanks to the lockdown. you anyways couldn't order food and all that. But then I reduced on oily stuff. I replaced gluten with, millets, which are far better, healthier options. I worked out kind of like every day. I used to have egg whites after that. So only the egg whites, not the omelets and all that. I would have ambil. I found a big, I was attracted to ambil. I didn't know what it was when you mentioned
ambil. Can you just tell it to people who don't know what ambil is?
Yeah. So ambil is basically nachni sattva. Yeah. So, I would have it with taak and with salt and some jeera powder on top of it. And I would have it. It would fill me till, I would have it at 9 o'clock. It would fill me till 11 o'clock, which is when I would take something else which was there on your diet. So, I was a big fan of ambil. I am a big fan of ambil. I would eat nachni laddus also, They are really good once in a while when I had too much craving.
Mostly you moved on to finding gluten-free options, which was still fitting into your diet. And I think we switched over your oil also and we started using this sattva oil, which is our product and which is a combination of a peanut oil and a safflower oil, exactly in the proportion needed by the body and anti-inflammatory. So this worked together. Manish, this is all I wanted to talk to you about. I hope all of you are listening to us have taken motivation from him. Arthritis, diabetes, thyroid, PCOD, bottom line is inflammation, and diet does have a big role to play in healing you. So with your medicines, please, you should seek a diet advice, not necessary that you need to come to us, but in whichever city you are, please seek medical advice, please seek a diet advice, see that, you're changing your diet in a healthy and awesome way. Okay, so Manish, thank you so much for joining me. Exit out so I can answer the questions or whoever have any other questions.
Thanks a lot. Thank you very much.
Okay, so I'm just quickly going to take the question because I think we have got limited time now. So let us just see. So let me just quickly take a few questions that you would have. So Pradeep here is asking, I have seen Manish in worst of pain, almost 8 to 9 watt scale, but after the diet he's okay. So that there was a positive review. Let us just see if there are any more questions. I hope you guys have enjoyed this session because my motive behind bringing two of my clients was, for y'all to understand, real life examples do exist. It's not, you might see fancy results only from film stars or, something which is you cannot really touch and feel that person you don't even know at all. So this was exactly the reason why I felt that, we have to talk with people who have shown results and diet has made a major difference. Losing 45 kgs or getting rid of the arthritis symptoms is something phenomenal, which I felt that it's very, very important for all of you to really understand. So one question over here was from, So ma'am, I have a digestive problem. I face problem in my stomach, usually constipation. So see, constipation could happen because of several reasons. The first reason why you could have constipation is because you're having less water. So see that you're having enough of water. Second thing is, if you're having constipation, see that you are having fruits and vegetables in your diet, salads, okay? So salads is your lunchtime and salads are your dinner time is a must, you should be having that. Apart from that, you also need to have 1 teaspoon of ghee either first thing in the morning when you get up on an empty stomach or 1 teaspoon of ghee before you sleep. That lubricates your entire digestive system and a constipation will be taken care of. And apart from that, what you also need to do is have 1 glass of buttermilk in the day without fail. That will also help you to tackle your constipation. I hope that helps you. Okay. Let me see. Okay. So I think I have taken most of the questions. So I'm concluding my session over here. I would like to thank all of you guys for joining me in this session. I hope there was a take home message for you. Diet does have a cure for a lot of disorders. And you wouldn't imagine also that, diet could be a cure for this disorder. Even like psoriasis, complication like psoriasis also has a diet. or you know even PCOS conditions can be reversed with the help of diet. Thyroid can be managed, medications can go down with the diet and the exercise you follow. So yes, you need to take a medical help to begin with, but you can move over to changing your lifestyle, changing your diet, and you will see a positive change. So thank you all so much for joining me in this live session. I will come up again with one more interesting live session. So stay tuned. Bye-bye. Take care. Stay safe. Bye.